So welcome friends. So in this particular session, we are going to discuss what are various career options for computer engineering graduates and how they can proceed for these particular options. Now this is the picture where you can find various question marks. So what are the career options? So everybody is thinking, what is career option after my graduation, after completing my computer engineering graduation? So what I will do? So there are many questions in mind. So in this particular session, I am going to give you some answers for that question. So what will be the career or what will be the options available in front of you? Now for computer engineering graduates, there are various options. There are huge number of options. So those options are divided into three categories. So first is job in private IT company. So you can have the jobs in private IT company. So that is the first option you can select. Then second option is public sector job opportunities. So you can join to the government jobs or public sector. That is the second job opportunity for the computer engineering graduates. And third option is career option is entrepreneurship. That is nothing but own firm. So you can start your own firm. So we will discuss one by one in detail what are the job opportunities in private IT company or in IT sector, then what are the options or things available in public sector, and what is meant by entrepreneurship. So this is nothing but the total outline of this particular session. So in first part of this session, so I will explain you what are the career options in IT industry. So there are lots of options, so that I will discuss one by one. Now first of all, what is meant by IT industry? So it is a business sector which consists of companies that produces software, hardware, or provides internet and internet related services. So it is a business sector which produces the software as well as hardware, or sometimes they are providing internet or internet related services. So normally people thought about IT career as programmer or software developer. But this is not the case, that there are only few options. So IT industry have huge number of job opportunities where one can do his career. So many IT jobs depends on strong technical knowledge, but each has different emphasis. As a sometime it is centered on coding, it centers on managing hardware or software, maybe data science or managing soft people or systems. So that is nothing but how the career is based. So here I will show you various career options in IT industry. So first is data analyst, option as a data analyst. Then there is option data scientist, business analyst, then cyber security specialist, database administrator, database analyst, hardware engineer, IT consultant, multimedia developer, network administrator, network engineer, programmer, system analyst, web developer, mobile developer, and so on. So those are some options. Those are not restricted. There are many other options are available. So I will explain one by one. Now the first option, that is the data analyst. So what is the data analyst? So he is gaining the insight of the data, insight from the data through analysis and interpretation. So what he is doing, he is working for the business or organizations to identify the problems and help them to solve that problems. So they are using programming and computer software skills to do statistical analysis of data, and through that they are getting some insights, and that can be helpful. So that is nothing but a job done by the data analyst. Now the next is data scientist. So data scientist, it is the broad career stream as a data analyst. So if you are becoming data scientist, you must be data analyst. So what is the data scientist is doing? So they are just not gaining the insights from the data, but they are also building the complex models, behavioral models using big data. So they are analytical experts who are creating the algorithms and predictive models. So how the business will work, how, or they will predict, they will create the predictive model. So that is nothing but the role of the data scientist. Now after data scientist, there is a business analyst. So this business analyst is examining the organization or part of the organization or the business to determine how to achieve the goal in better way. So they are helping the organization to achieve the goal in better ways. Now the next option is cyber security specialist. So he is protecting the security of computer system from the organization and network. So he must have the broad technical knowledge. As a cyber security expert, he must have the broad technical knowledge. He is helping or he is protecting the security of the computer system and the network from the organization. Now next option, as a career option, as a database administrator. So he is handling the database. He is handling the database security, integrity, and he is checking whether it is operating efficiently or not. So the database administrator is ensuring data standards, whether they are consistent, whether data is accessible by user whenever needed. If suppose any problem occurs in between to the user, he will help to the user. They are also involved in database planning and development. The next option is database analyst. So he is the person who is designing, implementing and evaluating the database of the organization. So he is organizing the collected information in terms of database, and sometimes the database analyst is updating and maintaining the existing database. So that is nothing but the role of the database analyst in the company or organization. Next option is hardware engineer. So hardware engineer, he works with the computer systems. As we know, hardware means the actual system. So he is working with the computer system, servers, routers, printers, and he ensures installation and testing of it. So he ensures whether they are installed properly, whether they are properly working. So he is testing it and installing it. So that is nothing but the work of the hardware engineer in the company. Now next career option is IT consultant. So normally IT consultant, he is the independent contractor. So he may be specialized in some fields like security, software, internet solution or web design. So IT consultant is he understands the customer requirements and provides the strategic advice. So he may be specialized in the single field or multiple field, and based on the customer requirement, he can provide the strategic advice to the customer to get the proper solution. Now next option is multimedia developer. So what the multimedia developer is doing in the company? So he is creating and manipulating multimedia content. So like educational products, entertainment products, multimedia presentations. So nowadays there are many softwares which are used for educational purpose, entertainment purpose, like games, education purpose, like softwares. So they are developing it. So actually they are skilled programmers, computer programmers, as well as they have some visual artistry. So they must combine both programming as well as visual artistry, and they are creating some multimedia content. The next option is network administrator. So what is the role of network administrator? He is maintaining and troubleshooting the computer network from the organization. Now he is also responsible for organization and maintenance of the computer systems. So he is maintaining and troubleshooting the network, as well as he is organizing and maintaining the computer systems also. So that is the role of network administrator. Next is network engineer. So network engineer, he is designing and setting up the computer network in companies. So as per the requirement, he is designing and setting up the computer network in the companies. So he is performing the duties like placing of the equipments, setting of it, activating the equipment, electronic equipment, putting the antennas, finding the coverage. So many things are performed by the network engineer. Now next option is programmer. So generally every company requires programmer with different language or in technology. So while software development, the programmer write a program in specific language as per the requirement and functions. So he also tests the softwares and sometimes update it. So every company wants a programmer as per their need in specific language or technology. So programmer is required. So this is nothing but the role of programmer. Next is system analyst. So he is introducing the computer system or modifying the existing system to increase the business productivity and efficiency. So he is analyzing the systems, current existing system. He will modify the existing system for increasing the business productivity. Next option as a career option, that is a web developer. So here the web developer designs and hosts the websites with the web pages and necessary database. So they are the skilled programmers and they are designing the pages, navigation, graphical user interface, and also they are doing some search engine optimizations. So that is nothing but a role of web developer. Next option is mobile app developer. So he is implementing and maintaining the source code for the mobile app. So as per the client requirement, and they are creating the user interface database as per the requirement of the client. So that is nothing but the role of mobile app developer. So those are the some options I have told. So there are other options like cloud engineer, who is handling the cloud of the companies or the data from the cloud. So that is nothing but various options. Other options are also available. So here we will discuss some top trending technologies in IT. The first is artificial intelligence and machine learning. So what is meant by artificial intelligence? It is nothing but creating intelligent machine. So that can simulate human thinking. Whereas machine learning, it is nothing but it is subset of AI. So where machine can learn by itself, so by own, without much programming. So that is nothing but machine learning. Next is robotic process automation. So it is also called as software automation. So it is nothing but business process automation. Next is virtual reality and augmented reality. So virtual reality, it is nothing but a computer generated world where human can interact. And in case of augmented reality, it is real world view with the additional computer generated enhancement. So real world view can be enhanced with the computer generated enhancements. Then cyber security. So it is nothing but a process or a technology to protect the computer systems, network, data from various attacks and unauthorized access. Then it is a blockchain. So blockchain is nothing but it is the growing list of records called blocks. It is a next it is Internet of Things. So it is related to reference to the billions of physical devices around the world which are connected to the internet. Next is cloud computing. So it is nothing but a delivery of on-demand computing services over the internet. Then big data analytics. So by using the advanced analytic techniques on very large and diverse data set. Now what is the organizational structure of any IT company? So normally people don't know the organizational structure of IT company. So if you see this is the first stage as a junior developer. So this is the entry phase where the person can enter into the IT company as a junior developer. After experience, he will become the senior developer. Then experience in the senior development as well as his team management skill, he may become the team leader. So there are multiple teams and that led by the team leaders. So there are various teams for one project. That teams are headed by the project manager. So project manager is over the team lead. Then in any company or in any IT company, there are various projects. So that the project managers are handled or controlled by the senior manager. And over the senior manager, there is a chief executive officer of that company. So this is nothing but a normal organizational structure. That structure may change, but it is a beginning point as a junior developer, junior programmer. Then after experience only he will become senior, then senior will become team lead, then project manager. Project manager is handling various teams, then senior manager, and over the top it is CEO, that is chief executive officer. So now here we will discuss the recruitment process in IT industry. Normally the process may change slightly, but this is some general process the IT industry is following. So they are receiving the applications, after that screening the applications as per their need, then they are taking the employment test like aptitude test or technical test, and they are shortlisting the candidates for the interview. So interview for the shortlisted candidate, there may be technical interview, after that there may be HR interview. So after having the interviews, they would shortlist some candidates and they will check the reference of that candidate. So through email or phone call they will check the reference, and there may be medical examination. After medical examination there will be final selection with the offer letter. So they are selecting the final candidates with the offer letter. So this is the normal process, recruitment process. There may be change. So they are receiving the application, screening the application, conducting the employment test, then they will interview the shortlisted candidate, then checking the reference, then medical examination. Sometimes there may be medical or may not be, then final selection with the offer letter. So what are the requirements as well as qualification requirements for better career in IT? So first requirement is you must have engineering degree from computer science or information technology. Second thing is you must have better knowledge of programming. So if you have better knowledge of programming, that will help for building the career. Next is better aptitude and logical reasoning. So your logical reasoning power as well as aptitude must be better. Then core subject knowledge from engineering. So you must have better core subject knowledge from the engineering subjects. And communication skill. You must have better communication skill. If you have those particular things, then definitely you will grow in your career. So here are the some major IT hubs in India where the person can go and do the jobs or continue his career. So first is Pune from Maharashtra, it is the IT hub. Then Hyderabad from Telangana, then Bangalore from Karnataka, then Chennai from Tamil Nadu, Kochi from Kerala, and Chandigarh. So those are the IT hubs. So there are companies in Mumbai, Delhi, and many other cities, but those are the major IT hubs in India. So this is the second part of this session. So where I will explain various competitive exams for computer engineering graduates, so through which he can enter into the government sector or he can join to the government jobs. So in this particular presentation, I am going to discuss what are various competitive exams for engineering graduates. Now there are huge number of opportunities in private or government sector through competitive exams for engineering graduates. But people are not thinking at the time of graduation. They are thinking or they are starting their thoughts after completion of the graduation. So always think and start preparing before completion of graduation. Now what are the various options or competitive exams available? So those are not restricted. There are many other options also. So few are here. Well, first is GATE exam or GATE. Second is various PSUs. Then RRB exam. Then UPSC, that is IAS, then UPSC IES, then MPSC exam, and Bank PO. So those are the some competitive or few competitive exams I am going to explain in this particular presentation. Now the first exam, that is the GATE. GATE means Graduate Aptitude Test in Engineering. So this Graduate Aptitude Test in Engineering, it is conducted by IITs once in a year. Now valid GATE score, it is useful for taking admission in ME, MTech, PhD. So that is nothing but the first benefit of GATE. Now the other benefits of GATE are, so many PSUs like BHEL, IOCL, NALCO, NTPC, HPCL, BPCL, DRDO, etc. So they are recruiting based on your valid GATE score. Also, many research institutes like PRC, CSIR, they are also recruiting through the GATE, but for that you must have the valid GATE score in that particular exam. Now in GATE exam, the GATE score will be valid for 3 years. So now we'll see various other parameters of the GATE exam. So first is eligibility criteria. So for GATE exam, the eligibility criteria is the student or the person should be currently in the final year of the graduation, or graduation should be completed. So then and then only he can give the GATE exam. Now this is the question paper format for the GATE exam. So there are total 65 questions for 100 marks. Out of 65 questions, 10 questions on general aptitude and 55 questions on related to discipline. If suppose you are giving the GATE exam for computer science or computer engineering, at that time 10 questions from the paper are on the general aptitude and 55 questions are from the computer science and engineering. So it is nothing but 10 questions cost 15 marks, as well as 55 questions, they are for 85 marks. Now questions, that what are the types of questions available? The questions are of type multiple choice questions or numerical answer type question. So in case of multiple choice question, you will be given 4 options and you have to select one correct option out of that. In case of numerical answer type question, you have to enter the answer based on your calculation. Now there is a negative marking for wrong answer in case of MCQs. So if suppose you are giving a wrong answer for the MCQ which having the mark for 1 mark question, so at that time your 1/3 marks will be deducted from the whatever score. In case of 2 mark MCQ, if it is wrong, then 2/3 marks will be deducted. But in case of numerical answer type question, there is no negative marking in case of GATE. Now next are the PSUs. So public sector undertakings. So those PSUs, those are owned by the government. They provide the recruitment based on GATE score, valid GATE score. Now what is the educational qualification required? So 60% or equivalent CGPA is required. And final year students can apply. And those who have completed the graduation, they also can apply for this post. But there is an age limit for the open category, that is up to 28 years. Of age you can apply for the PSUs. So what are various PSUs? I have already explained there are various PSUs like NALCO, ITPC or NTPC, BHEL, DRDO and so on. So those are the PSUs where you can go for the recruitment through the GATE score, valid GATE score. Now the third exam, that is RRB, Railway Recruitment Board. So Railway Recruitment Board conducts computer based online exam for various posts. So those posts will be technical or non-technical, and it is conducted every year. Now what is the procedure for RRB exam? So I am taking the example of Railway Junior Engineer exam pattern, or it is for Railway Junior Engineer exam. So there are the 4 stages. First stage is first stage CBT, means first stage computer based test. Then there will be second stage of CBT, that is second stage computer based test, then document verification and medical examination in case of Railway Junior Engineer exam. Now I will explain what is meant by first stage CBT, what is the pattern of that CBT, and second stage CBT means computer based test. So in first stage of CBT, this is the exam pattern I am going to explain. So there are 4 various subjects you have to prepare, that is mathematics, general intelligence and reasoning, general awareness, general science. So mathematics, there are 30 questions based on mathematics. There are 25 questions based on general intelligence and reasoning, 15 questions on general awareness, 30 questions on general science. So total questions, 100 questions for 100 marks, and duration is 90 minutes. So within 90 minutes, you have to solve those 100 questions, and there is a negative marking, 1/3 marks. So if you give wrong answer for one question, then the 1/3 mark will be deducted from that particular score. So this is nothing but how first stage of CBT exam pattern. Now in second stage of CBT, there are 5 various topics you have to prepare, that is general awareness, physics and chemistry, basic computer, basic environment and technical abilities. So in general awareness, there are 15 questions, physics, chemistry 15 questions, basic computer 10 questions, basic environment 10 questions, technical abilities 100 questions. So total 30, 40, 50, 150 questions you have to solve within 120 minutes of duration. So there is also negative marking of one third marks from the your score. So that is nothing but how first stage of CBT will be conducted, and this is the second stage of CBT, that is computer-based test, how that will be conducted. And after conducting first and second stage, if you qualify, then there will be document verification and medical examination. Now next exam is UPSC. So UPSC means Union Public Service Commission, which conducts the civil service exam every year to recruit prestigious positions in Government of India. So IAS exam is having the three stage process. This is the three stage process: first prelim, then mains, and then interview. So in IAS exam, you have to first give prelim, then main, and then age limit for this exam is 21 years to 32 years. And education required is up to graduation, or graduation, minimum graduation is required for the or this is the eligibility criteria for the UPSC. Now UPSC, as I had told, there are three stages: prelim, mains, and interview. So what is the UPSC prelim? So this exam consists of two papers. So there are two papers in prelim. First is general studies paper 1. It is MCQ based paper. There are 100 questions, and those are for 200 marks, and duration is 2 hours. And second paper is general studies paper 2. So this is also MCQ type questions. There are 80 questions, and for the score of 200 marks, and duration is also 2 hours. So there is a negative marking in the prelims. Now in mains, UPSC mains, if you qualify in the prelims, then you can be eligible for the mains. So this stage or main stage, this consists of 9 papers, and those all papers are descriptive type. So here you can see there are 9 papers. Paper A, that is Indian language, the marks are 300 marks, duration is 3 hours. Then paper B is English, subject English, marks 300 and duration is 3 hours. Then paper 1, this is essay writing, marks are 250 marks, duration is 3 hours. So all the duration is 3 hours for all papers. Paper 2, that is general studies. So you can have Indian heritage or culture, history and geography of the world and society. So that is nothing but general studies paper 1. So this is for 250 marks. Then paper 3, that is general studies paper 2, governance, constitution, social justice, international relations. Then paper 4, that is general studies 3, that is technology, economics development, biodiversity, environment, security and disaster management. And paper 5, it is general studies paper 4, ethics, integrity and aptitude. So all those paper are for 250 marks and duration is 3 hours. Now paper 6 and 7, they are optional subject 1 and optional subject 2. There is a list of subjects. Out of that subjects you have to select as optional subject 1 and optional subject 2, and the paper will be having that particular subject. Now in case of UPSC mains, paper A and B, if you take paper A and B, they are qualifying in nature. And all remaining papers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Total 7 papers are merit in nature. So candidate need to score 25% in each paper from paper 1 to 7. And the total marks are 750. So first A and B, they are qualifying in nature, and all remaining papers, they are merit in nature. So you must the merit is calculated based on paper 1 to paper 7, and total marks are 17,750 in case of UPSC mains. UPSC prelim is not considered for the merit. So only from qualifying UPSC prelim you will be eligible for UPSC main. Then UPSC interview. After qualifying into UPSC mains, so interview will be conducted. The marks for interview are 275 marks. So here many qualities are checked through the interview, and the final score, it is calculated based on UPSC mains and interview. Next exam is UPSC IES. So earlier was IAS, that is Indian Administrative Services, and this is the IES, means Indian Engineering Services. Now Indian Engineering Services or Engineering Service Examination, it may be called as Indian Engineering Services or Engineering Services Examination, that is conducted by UPSC for engineers and who works under Government of India. The person who is recruited, they are working in railways, power, telecommunication, central water engineering, defense service of engineering. Now, what is the age limit for UPSC? The person should be 21 to 30 years. So this is for open category. I am explaining for all related to open category. There is a variation for other categories. Then selection process, there is a prelim or preliminary exam, then main exam and interview. Recruitment done under following categories, that is electrical, mechanical, civil and electronics, civil and electronics and telecommunication. Now what is the format of UPSC IAS? First is preliminary exam. Preliminary exam contains two papers, paper 1, paper 2. Paper 1, it is general studies and engineering aptitude, which is objective type paper for 200 marks and duration is 2 hours duration. Paper 2nd is for based on engineering, it is objective type and 300 marks and with the 3 hours duration. Now in main exam, there are two papers. Paper 1, it is based on the discipline, engineering discipline. So it is descriptive type of paper for 300 marks each and duration is 3 hours. So there are two papers based on engineering knowledge and they are of 3 hours duration. Next exam is MPSC, that is Maharashtra Public Service Commission. So the recruitment exam, it is conducted by Maharashtra Public Service Commission for recruiting candidates in various departments of state government. So this is conducted by the state government to work under various departments of state government. Now what is the age limit for MPSC? Age limit is 18 years to 33 years old. Then education qualification, graduate, minimum qualification is graduation. The nationality required is Indian national can apply. Then what are the stages of the exam? There are also three stages, prelim, main and interview. Now what is the format of prelim, main in case of MPSC? So in prelim exam, there are two papers of one. There are two papers, paper 1, 100 questions, 200 marks and 2 hours duration. It is objective type and paper 2 is 80 questions, 200 marks, 2 hours duration and objective type. And in case of main exam, after qualifying from the prelim exam, you can apply for the main exam or you will be eligible for the main exam. Now we'll discuss about the main exam of MPSC. So in main exam of MPSC, there are total 6 papers, paper 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Paper 1, it is Marathi and English, where essay translation is available. So it is for 100 marks with a duration of 3 hours and it is descriptive type of paper. Now paper 2, it is Marathi and English, grammar and comprehension. It is also 100 marks, but the duration is 1 hour and which is MCQ type of paper. Then paper 3, 4, 5, 6, general studies 1, general studies 2, general studies 3, general studies 4. All the papers for 150 marks with the duration of 2 hours. And all are MCQ type of questions or MCQ type of papers. And after qualifying from the main exam, the person will be eligible for the interview. Now next exam, that is a bank PO, bank probationary officer. So it is a manager level post offered in public or private sector banks. Then what is the eligibility criteria? Which banks are offering the PO? What is the process? So I will explain one by one. So eligibility criteria, your age must be 20 to 30 years and education required is graduation. Now what are the various banks offering the PO? SBI, PNB, Bank of Maharashtra, Bank of Baroda, HDFC, ICICI, Corporation Bank and many more. Now the bank PO process, the exam process, so there are three stages. First is prelim exam, main exam and GD and interview. That is the third stage. Now what is the syllabus for exam? What is the syllabus for prelim exam? So in prelim exam, there is a English language, 30 questions, then quantitative aptitude, 35 questions and reasoning ability, 35 questions. And duration for this exam are the 60 minutes. Then the main exam. So in main exam, there are four type of questions. One is reasoning and computer aptitude, then data analysis and interpretation, general banking and economy, and English language. So based on reasoning and computer aptitude, there are 45 questions. Data analysis and interpretation, there are 35 questions. General banking and economy, 40 questions. And English language, 35 questions. And duration for the exam is 180 minutes. Now, those both the tests are MCQ type of test. And there is one descriptive test of 50 marks for 30 minutes with two questions in that test on the English, that is essay and letter writing. So descriptive test, one descriptive test in main exam, not in prelim. And both the prelim as well as main exam, whatever discussed earlier, those are the MCQ type of questions. And there is a descriptive test in main exam, other paper with the 50 marks, and where you have to write the essay or essay and letter. Now, what are other exams available? There is a list, huge list of exams. First is UGC NET exam, then Mahajan Co exam, then Staff Selection Commission exam, then RBI Grade B exam. So there is a list of exams where you can apply after completion of your graduation, and you can thought about that exam before graduation. So this is the third part of the session. So where I will explain what is by entrepreneurship and how this option will be beneficial for the computer engineering graduates. So first of all, what is meant by entrepreneurship? So entrepreneurship is nothing but the entrepreneur who creates and runs new business to gain the profit by taking risks from the business world. So simply, entrepreneurship means starting a new business or starting the firm to gain the profit by taking the risks from the business world. So computer graduates can start his own firm, and he can move ahead in this particular path. So that is nothing but entrepreneurship. So entrepreneurship is one option for the computer graduates, and there are various advantages. So the benefit of that advantages can be taken by the computer graduates. So what are the advantages for the computer engineering graduates? So whenever he wants to open a new firm, so he requires less infrastructure. So that is the first advantage he can take, that is a less infrastructure requirement. Within a small space, he can start his own firm. Less number of equipments, he can start his own firm. So few PCs and some connectivity, so he can start his own firm. So that is nothing but the first advantage which the computer engineering graduates can take, and he can start his own firm. Now what is the second advantage? Within the less manpower, he can run his business. So there is no huge requirement of manpower. Few people can run their own firm along with the owner. Now less number of permissions from the government authorities, because this the firm which is related to IT sector, which is related to computer sector, so that is not creating pollution, that is not creating many issues, so that there are very less permissions from government authorities. So that is also the advantage for opening the own firm as a computer engineering graduate. So this is the option. I'm telling the options, the various options for after graduation. So this is the one more or one option for taking his career ahead. Thank you for watching this session. I think this is very helpful session for all the people who are attending. So you can pass on this particular message to your friends so that they can take the benefit of it. Thank you. Thank you one and all.